I am of the opinion, I could be wrong, that Kyra and that show is what is responsible for the current fashion of bringing women with maturity back into head-up shows. I think Kyra single-handedly accomplished that. She is a genius as an actor. And everybody's, you know, everybody has their issues and their problems, but Kyra is a goddamn genius. And the fact that she had so much weight and it was so successful, I really think she's responsible for this new movement. And we are the better for it. There's great women out there. Before that, on LA Law, we would just occasionally have a great part for a woman of a certain age. And the women who would come out of the woodwork to audition for that part because there was no work for them shamed me. I felt embarrassed that these women had to do this, were there, dressed to the nines, ready to go. It was not a great time for women. Television has really, you know, as we're talking about all of this, Aaron Spelling was the first guy who realized what a wealth he had available to him. He did it differently than we all might, but he employed all those women. And there's a really long drought of significant work for 40-year-old women. So I'm happy. She should take pride and pleasure in that part of her contribution.
As a director of several of the episodes, was there anything different about how you approached it just because of the fact of either to highlight or to be able to use the strength of that lead in a way that affected how you directed? Or was it all in the script? Or
it was in the script.
Okay.
I mean, the stories were set up to do that for her. The, you know, in that kind of a show, Kyra was the star, and deservedly so. So there was just a little schmoozing and wrangling that had to be done for all the guys that supported her, because Kyra needed... She had not done television before. And the first year, she was so exhausted. She hadn't learned, like we all have to learn, how to marshal your energy, what questions you have to answer, what you can ignore, how you can preserve yourself. She hadn't learned any of that. She thought she had to be there every instant of every moment and answer every question and be there for every actor. And she was near dead by the end of the first season. She got far more sophisticated about that as time went on. And really your job was to, once again, I mean, I feel like so often this is the case with directors, whether they understand it or not, your job is to protect them, to give them room, yes, and protect them, and let them do what they are better than anybody else at doing. And Kyra needed a little protection because of her wish to be there for everything. You had to be careful about, like I had to be careful about too many takes. And then she got sophisticated so that she could say, is this the take? Is this the place where I have to deliver, or are we still out here in some wide, weird shot?
Right.
You know what I mean? It's like she needed to know that, and that helped her preserve her energy.
And probably helped her because she's now directed, I believe.
Yeah, so. I think she has. Yeah. And she should. She's a really, really smart, capable, talented person.